little embarrassing. You got a 15-year-old kid telling you how to mine, but he's got a lot more experience than I do.
Hey, Parker.
Todd.
How are you, buddy?
Pretty good.
Parker just happened to be mining nearby with his grandpa, John. When the Hoffman showed up, he stopped by to check out their operation.
You'll need a valve on each of those to regulate the flow, because you'll need, I think my grandpa said it's supposed to be 8 pounds of pressure. It's tough. It's tough. It takes a lot of money to start a mine like this. You know, find a place where you're going to dig and get your dirt ready so that when everything's up and running, you can start putting it through the plant, because you're not going to make any money until you start up.
I think very early on, we knew this kid had something. We definitely had a spark. He had like a little twinkle in his eye. He was funny. He was going right at, you know, an adult. He was just ripping Todd openly.
After being just the kid next door in season one, in season two, Parker became the boss at Big Nugget Mine.
Pretty sure we fixed it.
Growing up, Parker mined with his grandpa during the summers. But this season, Grandpa John handed over the reins of the mine to his young grandson.
Thanks, Grandpa.
The 92-year-old veteran miner would help him out here and there, but all the big decisions were now up to Parker.
Parker is sitting on top of the world. He has visions that he's going to make thousands of dollars every day, and I hope he's right.
Parker suddenly became the boss of the other Big Nugget miners, and they weren't quite sure what to make of their new teenaged mine boss.
Yeah, you can run the excavator, and Gary, you can run the truck. I guess that's a no.
All right, so let's move on to Parker. Parker Schnabel.
Parker Schnabel.
Parker Schnabel.
In season two, Parker was in his first year as a mine boss, running his grandpa's mine, Big Nugget, in Alaska.
The more we peeled layers away, the more we saw how sweet the relationship with his grandfather was. I mean, and John is a salt of the earth, Alaskan guy, huge character. So I think very quickly we realized we had something special there.
There's got to be something in the water in Alaska, Parker. You got a teenager mining and a 91-year-old running around a gold mine. That doesn't happen in the lower 48. Just doesn't.
My grandpa just, you know, doesn't stop. And he always talks about it. Oh yeah, well, I better do it while I'm still alive, or, you know, that's a pretty common phrase.
How do you think he's made it to 91 and 91 still mining?
Gold mining is great for retired, like retirement for him, especially because you never get done what you want to get done.
There we go.
Never. You never see a gold miner that says, oh yeah, I'm happy with where this season ended.
He can't stop, he's addicted. What's the fondest memory you have of spending time with your grandfather?
I was probably about 6 or 7. We were panning by the creek. I had a little pan going, and the wind picked up and blew my gold pan full of gold down the creek, and it all flew all over the place. And I started to cry. He snuck away and like got some dirt and put some gold in it and brought it back over. And he was like, forget about it. Here, come pan some more. And you know, I found like twice as much as I had. Those kind of things really planted the seed for me to have the love for it that I do.
Between Parker's passion for mining and his knack for it, the sky was the limit. His biggest roadblock was probably his mom, Nancy. She clearly saw a different future for her son.
You know, that would be just if I were the producer.
Well, let's be honest, you're kind of a producer of Gold Rush.
I am kind of a producer of Gold Rush. No.
No, this is, producer Nancy.
Executive producer Nancy.
Nancy was truly worried about him. You know, he was like a little kid on a TV set, and I vowed to be her eyes and ears.
I wish that would have just came right out, but that'd be too easy.
And I really looked out for him. I mean, he kind of called me like his TV dad for a little while.
Well,
so Nancy, I'm assuming that you are fine with Parker becoming a gold miner, perhaps even skipping college.
Not even a little bit, no. Not at all. My concern is that Parker will have a great season next summer, that he will be extremely motivated, and he will know so much more than he did this summer, that he'll really hit it and hit it hard, and he will not be able to close it down.
Right.
You know.
So you want him to do well, but not too well.
Well, if he does really well, and we can all
retire.
You know.
Is that what's going to happen, Parker?
I don't know.
What do you think's going to happen?
I'll just drop out now.
Yeah, that's not going to happen.
What does Dad think?
Go to school.
Yeah, I think he's a little worried.
Well,
they're both worried.
As I told Parker, he's been roaming around the house saying, I'm not going to college. I don't want to go to college. I don't need to go to college.
I said that like once.
You said it more than
once. No, I didn't.
Then he comes
to me. And you just roam around the house all day?
Yeah, he roams around the house all day.
Just roam around.
And then he comes to me and says, Mom, I think I could mine up until, you know, October next year and then just take the first semester off and go second semester. What do you think?
Yeah, and it will take 8 years to graduate from college if you do.
That, yeah.
You're fine with that.
Oh, I'll be that guy that's like 28.
Right.
Yeah, you'll be that guy.
At the end of season two, Parker's first as a full-time mine boss, he only banked 35 ounces.
Let's see what the plant can handle.
But coming off a poor season, his confidence was shaken.
I'm Parker Schnabel, and I mine gold.
And I'm supposed to find gold.
That's why I said I mine gold.
I mine gold.
Nevertheless, the young mine boss had sights set high.
This season, we had set a 300-ounce goal. You know, that's pretty optimistic. A lot more than we got, almost 10 times of what we got last season.
But he still had a lot to learn about how to be a mine boss and manage people, including gold recovery expert, Glenn.
You plugged into the wrong outlet up here. You plugged into the old one, which was tripping the 110 breaker.
You've got problems right out of the gate with this guy. Does he have a problem working in general or working with you? What's the deal?
I think he's a little bit, he is a little bit obsessive.
So he's just a little bit clueless or what?
No, I think he just, you know, focuses on a task and doesn't think about the consequences, you know?
Oh, Parker. I thought you were clear.
Yeah, well, I'm under here, Glenn,
yeah.
You know?
Yeah, I know. I thought you had your fingers out of the way.
To help him on his second season as mine boss, Parker brought along some buddies as well, like family friend Austin Nickerson.
I know Parker basically because my dad has worked with his dad for 20-some years, and then Parker called me, so just things just fell into place, basically. And yeah, this was a great opportunity, and I couldn't pass it up.
And another friend, a musician named Rick Ness.
You know, the three of us had a really good time for a while.
So, like, all three of you are young, immature,
right.
Goofy,
and Rick,
like to have a lot
Rick is just as immature as Austin and I. Yeah.
And Rick's 30?
Yeah.
Sleeveless shirts, lots of tats.
I actually grew up in Escanaba, Michigan, and my dad owns a construction company, so I did this off and on all growing up. And then all the whole time I was doing music, I was also doing a little bit of construction on the side.
Season three, Parker and his crew of young guns went all out.
Oh, yeah.
But it was clear that he was running out of good ground at Big Nugget.
The material's changing. There's no gold in it. I don't want to be hauling useless material to the plant.
Determined to land a big score, Parker turned his attention to a piece of virgin ground on Smith Creek. He attempted to mine an untouched part of the claim that was difficult to get to.
Find the hole!
It didn't pan out.
No gold.
So he turned to Emerson Trench, and he hit a hot spot.
Holy cow, that is amazing.
43 ounces.
Holy cow.
Well, this is the stuff that dreams are made of right here. This is great.